So in this video, we're looking at the method of undetermined coefficients, which is amazing. I call this two because in the other one, we only did like e to the blah blah x and then like polynomials. But this one is super awesomer because we have sines and cosines. And by super awesomer, I mean, whenever you start taking derivatives of sines and cosines, what could possibly go wrong, right? Okay, so basically, this is just kind of to separate this out just to give you a little bit of practice and confidence maybe with method of undetermined coefficient, which is fun to say because it's kind of like muck. You get some experience with muck before you do muck on sines and cosines. Okay, so basically the idea is the same. You're going to solve a homogeneous problem, and then you're going to make a guess for the particular. Now your guess, however, is going to be altered by a couple of things. So you've got some polynomial here and some polynomial here. You're going to choose the highest degree of these two in order to make your guess. And you use that for both. And that'll make sense in a second. So that's going to be the highest degree. Choose the highest degree for guess for both. I'll write that again, I guess. So the idea would be that if I had something that was like, you know, x, the first one was like x squared plus blah, 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 times cosine something or other. And then I had x to the fifth, blah, 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 blah. That's a five. That's really hard to see. X to the fifth, blah, 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 times sine something or other. Then whenever you did your guess, it would be a x to the fifth plus b x to the fourth plus c x cubed plus d x squared. I shouldn't have picked that, such a stupid. Plus f times cosine omega x. This is for your particular guess. And then plus what comes after f, g x to the, so yeah, we clearly would not want to solve this in real life. I can't, what comes after G? Algeria, Bulgaria, Gambia, Pakistan. All right, this is, I've completely lost track of H, I, J, K. Okay, sine omega X. All right, so you kind of get the idea is that you choose the highest degree, so whichever one of those is highest, then that one has to dominate across both of the guesses. And then also, if cosine of, you know, whatever you happen to have is in the homogeneous solution, then you have to put an x in. So after you would do all that, if the cosine of blah 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 was in the homogeneous solution, then in front of all this you would put x and x, basically increasing the derivative, or increasing the order by one. So I don't mean like start with the x to the sixth and go down to a constant, because you see this is no longer going to be a constant. It's going to be kx or fx, so you're actually not going to have a constant term. So that's why I say put the x out front. I do recommend multiplying everything out before you start taking derivatives, because this gets super fun. Okay? Got it. Okay, so say you had a problem that looked like this. You've got this nice little constant coefficient, second order linear differential, ordinary differential equation on the left. On the right, you've got this thingy with sines and cosines. So with all of these, you're always going to start off solving for the homogeneous solution. So I can write my characteristic equation. Plus 1 equals 0, so I have r plus 1 squared. So I have r is equal to negative 1 with a multiplicity of 2. So my homogeneous solution, e to the negative x, c2x. So that's beautiful, and I'm excited, and it's fantastic. Now, for guessing my particular solution, first of all, I want to see, is cosine and sine of 2x, are those over here? And the answer is no. No, so I'm good. I don't have to worry about adding any extra x's. All right. Now, the highest degree, this is a first degree, or I guess it's, yeah, first degree polynomial. This is a zeroth degree polynomial. So I need to guess ax plus b for the cosine of 2x. And then I would need to guess cx plus d for the sine of 2x. So basically you want to match the degree of the polynomial, the highest one, on both of them. Now, of course, the fun part of this is actually solving it. So if I take the first derivative, you know, you've kind of got to be super careful in how you do this, because you've just got product rule out the wazoo. So I'm going to go ahead and do that for you. So there, magically, are your two different derivatives, your first derivative and your second derivative, and then magically I'm going to plug them in. So to make my life easier, one of the things that I did is I just did the coefficients in front of the cosine 2x, so I just did all the cosine 2x terms first, rather than having to write everything out at once. It's a little risky from an algebraic perspective, but I'm going to think it's worth it, and then I'm going to do the sine ones next. And that's what I end up with on that one. Now my next step is going to be to simply go about and solve this algebraically. And I end up with this right here. And I end up with this over here. So I've got, now notice that this is equal to zero because there's no zero coefficient, or there's a zero coefficient for the x term over on this side. And now it's just a system of four equations and four unknowns. And then I'm going to say from there that clearly, and I had no ways to calculate or to figure this out at all, here are coefficients for A, B, C, and D, which essentially means that we can go back to our original equation, which I've long since forgotten what we were even doing this for. All right, so that's C1, I'm looking up here, C1 e to the x, C2 x e to the negative x. Okay, so I had my full solution is C1 e to the negative x plus C2 x e to the negative x, and then my particular solution, which was in some other form, again, I've long since forgotten, it's this guy right here. So the ax plus b and cx plus d. Ax plus b, so whatever this is, so x plus b, and this was times cosine of some kind of 2x, yeah. And then cx plus d, and I gotta keep zooming out because this just gets bigger and bigger. Times the sine of 2x, and assuming I didn't make some other kind of major problem algebraically along the way, although of course no promises, this is basically the idea of what you would do for all of these, and I just kept pausing it because I really didn't think you wanted to watch. So that's just kind of walking you through it one time, and for the rest of it, all we're going to do is just work on getting good guesses. Okay, so here are five problems to look at. Notice that the last two are specifically termed super awful. That means if you really want to go through and solve them by hand, you're certainly welcome to do so. I'll even give you the answer for one of them, but honestly, you're pretty much on your own. So pause the video. Remember, all you want to do is make guesses for particular solutions. So that is going to involve solving a homogeneous equation first, then the particular. So pause the video, see how far you can get. Okay, so let's pretend you did that. Now let's start with the first homogeneous problem. We have r squared plus 4 is equal to 0. That means r is equal to plus or minus 2i, is that right? Yes, okay. So that means that my homogeneous solution is e to the 0x, because there's no real part, so go c1 cosine 2x and c2 sine 2x, beautiful. So now I'm going to guess a particular solution. Now, unfortunately, my particular solution also has two x's in it. So, meh. So I've got to go come up with something good. So my guess is going to be, normally it'd just be a cosine 2x, sine 2x. But because I share a coefficient or share a homogeneous solution, that just means I need to put an extra x in there. And that's it, I'm good to go. Fantastic, let's do the next one. All right, for this one again, we're gonna solve the homogeneous problem. The homogeneous problem is r squared plus, ooh, I left that off. Sorry about that, guys. 3, I hope that was obvious and you didn't even notice it wasn't there. If you did, well, solve it now. You haven't lost anything except, you know, learning stuff. I mean, but you did learn stuff, so you didn't lose anything. R plus 2, r plus 1. So r is equal to negative 2 or negative 1. So I've got a homogeneous solution, c1 e to the negative 2x, c2 e to the negative x. My guess, oh, I'm actually in good shape here. I don't have any e's in here, so I don't have to worry about any extra x's. I'm going to pick the one with the highest power, and that's going to be the 20x plus 16. So this is very similar to the one that we worked out by hand. So I'm going to go ax plus b, cosine x, and cx plus d times the sine of x. And there we go. I would solve for those and then combine them. This one may end up being a little bit trickier. R squared plus 1 is equal to 0, so r is equal to plus or minus i
so my homogeneous solution is C1 cosine x and C2 sine x. Now I can see that that is in fact the same thing, cosine and cosine, and not just the fact that it's a cosine, but it's specifically a cosine, so really you'd emphasize the x. It's the cosine of x and the sine of x, not the sine of 3x or a different kind of x. It's the actual cosine of an actual x. So that's when I need to know that ultimately I'm going to have to multiply my final solution by another x in my final particular proposal. All right, so they're both first order, whatever you call those thingies with numbers in them, polynomials. It's a first order polynomial. So initially I would ask ax plus b cosine x. This would be my normal guess. But since my particular solution has the same thing as a homogeneous solution in it, that means I need to go in here and multiply by x again. So to make things simpler, whenever I actually have to go take derivatives of all these, rather than having three terms that I'm product ruling, I can just throw that, absorb it into there, so I only have two terms that I'm product ruling. Like that. Fancy? All kinds of fancy. So this one was the first of our simply awful problems, super awful problems. So I want to find the homogeneous solution. So r squared minus 3r plus 2 equals 0. R plus, no, minus r minus 2, r minus 1. So r is equal to 2 or 1, which means my homogeneous solution is c1 e to the 2x and c2 e to the x. Now this is actually quite relieving because see, this is e to the negative 2x, which is not the same thing as e to the 2x. So that means that I don't have to worry about throwing in an extra term, okay? I'm also going to identify which has the highest degree polynomial, and it's going to be that double one right there. Okay, so I'm going to guess a particular solution of e to the minus 2x times ax plus b cosine 3x, and then cx plus d, and you can't see what I'm doing anymore, sine 3x. Now, if you so happen to want to go through and work all of this, I've got like probably lots and lots of math pages that whenever I actually did this by hand a couple of times, and ultimately, you're going to end up with, just in case you care, a is 7, b is 1, or yeah, c is 1 and d is a negative 2, which is desperately disconcerting after all of that work. So you could combine those two to get the full solution. All right, one more. And here she is. Look at her, isn't she pretty? All right, we're going to find the homogeneous solution. R squared plus 2r plus 5 is equal to 0. Oh, I can't stupid this. B squared minus 4ac. I guess I could probably do this, maybe? I don't know, I could probably do some kind of completing the square of b squared minus 4ac over 2a, but I just don't want to work that hard. Do, 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 do. Now minus 16. So, 4. So I've got that r is equal to minus 1 plus or minus 2i. All right, well that's at least interesting. So my homogeneous solution is e to the negative x times c1 cosine 2x plus c2 sine of 2x. Now, this is where my particular solution makes me sad because I can see here that I have that combination. So this is one solution and this is the other. So I've repeated my whatever you call it, I've repeated my homogeneous solution inside what I would normally want to guess for my particular solution. That said, I can go ahead and I can match. So I've got e to the minus x. I want to match the highest degree polynomial, so that's just going to be ax plus b cosine 2x, cx plus d sine 2x. And then I need to recognize that because I have matched my solution for the particular solution in the homogeneous solution, I just need to throw an extra x in there. So again, I recommend distributing that across so that whenever you take the derivative, it's just one less thing that you have to worry about. But again, you just double derivative, plug it in, solve for the coefficients, and that's all you've got.